Hello, boys and girls. Welcome to Take Over My Shoulder in Call of Pripyat Special Edition, and I've made it in. Last time the jump didn't work because I was standing in the wrong spot. So you should be standing atop the pipe, or at least in this region. When you're standing over here, the grenade will blast you onto the fence, and there's an invisible wall there which you can't pass. I'm gonna explore this roof a little bit. I don't know if it has any additional walls in place. Also, health check. Goody. I have equipment and provisions for several days, so I think I first discovered this way in when I was trying to find a way up this tower just for fun. But still, I don't want to go too far back into the compound because I really don't know if there might be any additional walls, so let's start exploring. I hope the weather will improve. Although Twilight Zone is nice every time of the year, but some sunlight wouldn't hurt. Also, I don't know if it shows or not, but I have amped up the rendering a little bit. I switched from, I think I had it on DX9 and I switched to DX11, because I remembered I can do that now. Let's put the pistol away because we don't really need it here. Some of the structures. Okay, this structure is merely walk through but not fall through. It's not like the railway in Shadow of Chernobyl NPP level. So this whole episode is going to be a very, very, very calm, slow burn. Hello! Twilight Zone, and that's it. Huh. The shed even has a backside. Save actually. I don't think I did that. Yeah. Ooh, living on the edge. Ah, okay, that's a corner, not the corner. The corner is farther away. I'm still gonna equip the detector because you never know what the zone might give. I example, in Lost Alpha, in the Darkscape level Twilight Zone, there is a working ladder. Fill my heart with joy. I wouldn't hope that much here, but yeah, I don't think these are solid structures anyway. Nope. Farm set up here. Ah, let's just visit the edge some more. Speaking of different Twilight Zones, swamp map at Twilight Zone in Clear Sky is also very, very rich, not to mention large. I'm not even gonna compare Lost Alpha Twilight Zone. Some of those are almost as big as the rest of the map itself. Let's see, if I look at the map, what will it show? Okay, map still shows Jupiter. I don't think there is any overlap between the maps in this instance. Okay, this is the corner. I think it's time for a little snack. Yoink. Also, we have drugs. I'm gonna find myself a nice spot and then we're gonna get high. Dry spot. Okay, so there's more of these. Wait. Screenshot. There's more of these semi-industrial, semi-agricultural vistas here. This particular view actually invokes the same feel that I had when reading the roadside picnic itself. Can't remember exactly what the what part of it was. I mean, if I saw it in the book, I would recognize it. Solid. Nope. There's something about the industrial buildings that reminded me of that. Works at picnic, I mean. Also, I do hope I am recording this, because if I don't, then I'm gonna repeat the whole endeavor in a slightly more annoyed voice. Keep your detect route, Major. Never know what the zone might give. I think we're next to the helicopter crash site now. The one by the minefield. Ah, no, not yet. Okay, there's the perimeter. Screenshot! Ah, and this is the crash site. So yes, if you are not inclined to lure a chimera after you, and have it clear the mines for you, then one easy hustle-free way to get to the chopper is from here through the Twilight Zone. We are not gonna do this right now because I want to explore the rest of the map. Oh hey, this is solid. I think oftentimes the structures closest to the actual in-game area tend to be solid. Oh no, that's as far as I can. Yay, levitation is fun. Okay, what's over there? Bushes. Naturally, I will check the bushes for stashes because my brain is broken at this point and I cannot not look. This is some pretty standard forest here. Or, well, sparse trees, more like it. Oh, I know what I should do. Since we're out in the greens, I should have myself some vodka. Let us continue. See, even the zone agrees. A very peculiar sight in this general area. That's when I was changing the rendering and I was checking how it works and so on. And over there, at the concrete basin, I ran into a zombified fending off frayed pseudodogs, or more like three pseudodogs trying to have a go at the one zombified. He kept shooting them. I think he shot one of them, and then they kept biting him, and he kept falling down and doing his twitchy dance, and then get back up. And it took like 5 minutes or so But in the end it was zombified 3 to the dog 0. And I actually captured it, so I will upload it after this episode as a little groovy supplement. I wonder if water is also radioactive in the Twilight Zone. I mean, why wouldn't it be, but... you know... okay, I'm gonna keep the same loadout. Around a little bit. I think I might actually be close enough to the campsite that bandits will yeah, kill the radioactive. But the bandits will go on alert. Also captured one day. These particular bandits here are impervious to blowouts, I guess because they have their little plop task or whatever. Heyo! Okay. Too much contamination. But at the same time, they are definitely not impervious to mutants. So if I keep poking around in this area frequently enough, they totally will get some visitors. Well, even if I don't keep moving around, I think the pseudodogs still run into the area. Okay, let's get out of the water. Whoop! But yeah, if you're poking around in that area and over that bridge and don't get into a direct fight, you can still get rid of all those bandits if you're so inclined. I think in my first game I had the zombie fight, get rid of them. I can't remember if it was an accident or if it was a premeditated act of getting them after me and then bringing them to the bandits. And here we have the Jupiter Industrial Complex, shown in hindsight. I'm going to be very careful because I think there might be a fence here. Which I can't see from this side. I'm not sure if this structure is... I know, I think this structure is still inside the Twilight Zone. Let's try it. Okay, the structure is in the Twilight Zone. In that case, I want to check this ladder. Doesn't... no, no, it's not operational. Okay. Rain all day now. The weather was fine before I restarted the game and reloaded a few times ago. Well, which to be fair was a few days ago, but still. Nope. a real ladder. Would I be able to poke? No, this is a solid board. Okay. Ha. Of course, I'm gonna take advantage of this wonderful foggy weather and make all the screenshots. More bushes. Okay, what do we have here? Okay, this is the Jupiter complex proper now. It was on a slope. Are these like solid? Yes, solid gates. I mean, in a physical world one would be able to roll in from under the gates, but not here. I don't think you can crouch that deep. Okay, that's where one of the S.T.A.L.K.E.R. group stashes is. I'm in a garage! Whee! In my hometown there used to be a row of garages just like these by the railroad. But then they got making shit all nice and modern and they took them down. Installed a safe zone or whatever. There. Well, well, well. Pripyat proper. This is where we take the tourist screenshots. Because I can. So this point here would be another place where we can easily pop back in all these slopey locations are like this. From here actually maybe not that much. Remember. I mean it's always easier to get back in than you know up for a screenshot. Yes, more thunder, please. Aha! Wouldn't it be a bummer if you were motoring a boat in this urban landscape and suddenly somebody shot you from the rooftop? Like, you were just minding your own Twilight Zone business and then it turns out that there are monoliths on the rooftop still. Oh, okay, I'm inside the garage, I think. Just right. Let's take some classic tourist shots. And let us continue. Also save just in case. These garages are small enough for the most stalkerly. I mean, they are small enough. They're so small that they can only accommodate the most stalkerly vehicle, the Zaporozhets. First thing is that my Russian is just poor enough that I only get part of that joke. The Zaporozhets is supposed to be the most stalkerly vehicle because it has the baggage hatch in front for easy access, I think. But I didn't get the rest of the joke, so there's that. More screenshots with thunder. Yes, please. There's a really nice road going that way to north over there. Yeah. Continuing from the bridge. Tired, huh? Let's eat something. If I eat two breads, nah, didn't do anything. Oh, okay, we still haven't taken any drugs, so let's find a very, very nice spot. Like this, I think. This is a nice view. You can see the concrete factory and Pripyat town and the bridge and everything. I hope we won't roll down the rail, down the slope. Oh yes. Hydrogel, huh? Well, what did it say again? These capsules hold hydrogen. Made of two something something ingredients. Something an amount of sugar cube, I think the idea is that even though they are just the size of a sugar cube, they fill you up. I think these are not the drugs I was looking for. These are the drugs I was looking for. These are just quick forwarding of hunger. Okay. Well. Far out, man. I don't feel anything. Should I take more? Woo! I don't wanna fall into this. Ah, okay, the fence is over there, so I'm still safely on this side. So, what does it say? They have stimulating narcotic properties, I guess? Okay, so the at first intake it stimulates the brain. And I think you shouldn't mix them with other shit. So maybe that's what I did wrong, I took the hunger pills as well. Oh well, such is life in the Twilight Zone. Ooh, careful there. So, do we get some sunlight or what? Ahead we have these nice cottages and classical outhouses. Okay, the village makeup is actually very similar to that on the opposite side of the Twilight Zone. From here it is actually possible to hunt the bloodsuckers. Also I think from here. What's happening there? Somebody's looking for artifacts, I think. Oh no! It's Steve! And Josh? Sup, I don't know if all three actually spawn when you don't have the quest active, but ah, there is Rusty. How you doing, man? Also, Rusty was a sneaky Snorkelblade reference. Ooh, nice view. Screenshot. Also, I have a little drop of vodka left in my glass. Let's rectify that. Is pepper and honey vodka, if anyone asks. Hello? Anybody in here? Oh, but they do have TV. I think this is the one that I call the best outhouse in the Twilight Zone. Tree is solid. This village is almost like a satellite or extension of the radiated village, even though there is a gap between them. Okay, careful now, I don't want to fall into the proper zone. Let's see if we can titillate the bloodsuckers. Oh, there's an artifact there. Chemical vapors, and something is disrupting it. Yeah, an artifact there. What else do we see? Oh, okay. I thought we were more that way, but we're right behind this train stop. Nope. No loot here. Close to the fence again, so I'm gonna back up a little. What do we have over there? Piggy! Just Piggy, or are they fighting somebody? Ah, pseudo dogs. Of course. Now, this particular area here always reminds me of the clear sky swamp Twilight Zone. I guess it's because it's similarly positioned in relation to the main map. And also the high tension towers and the empty planes and all that. And also railroad is pretty close. Nobody here. And it's still raining, come on. I wanna see some sun and all that. Oh, we're a little tired. What's this? That is the coagulant. Oh, and this is the point where we're very close to the perimeter again. Hello. Wow, the planes actually extend further away. Okay. The slopes like these are usually the first locations where I try finding an entry point, because if you sprint downhill, then you gain some jump boost. It doesn't always work, but in certain cases it can. Just go touch the edge of the world once more, and then circle back. So yeah, this farm cottage complex is like the extension of the irradiated village, not the other one. Some sort of horizon there, but let's be careful. Aha! At least we have some thunder to spice things up. Also might be wise not to haul along a whole arsenal, a batch of mutant parts. Building, or like only chimney standing kind of structure, is pretty much identical to that inside the raided village, except well, that one is a solid structure. Yay, more rain! Okay, the perimeter is over there. Oh, so all this area here is actually Twilight Zone, okay. Yeah, because when coming from the village, then it looks as if this area is part of the main map. But it's not. Hee. another outhouse. Nearing to the end of the round. So let's step into water. Before. So if I'm here, when I was here, I should have looked where it shows me next to Pripyat. Oh well, some other time. And here, the lake or the pond or whatever. Actually connecting to the pond that's inside the map, I think. Anything to declare? No. Yeah, that's the over there. I can't see them. Floor is lava. Run, 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 run. Okay. Attaboy. Okay, I think I'm too far to get the contact. And we are almost back where we started. And the weather hasn't improved one bit. So, this has been a little very casual Twilight Zone stroll over the Jupiter map. I'm going to end this episode here now. Ah, okay. Now they're in the range. We're going to end this episode here. Next time, I will continue with regular adventures. Thank you very much for watching. See you then. And bye-bye!